My grandfather lay on that bed bare and exposed. Skin falling off bone, his eyes were closed tombs, his hair was a Polaroid scrapbook. You could read if you looked close enough, but I was always, always too afraid. His body looked like it had been pulled from under a pile of corpses at Auschwitz, and my father lathered his leathery legs that reminded me of mine with jerkins. The lunch lady names me the jerkins boy because of my smell. You know, he had swollen kneecaps. I got mine from wrestling. I always used to take shots the wrong way. Now it aches in the wintertime when I walk. I can only imagine, y'all, he guys is doing something way more noble, like praying. My grandfather was sick. My grandmother always tells the story of him coming home after going ghost for 2 whole months. She says, he walked in the house and smelled the way he always used to. Like he had a slur. Walking around, stumbling over imaginary shit, he said, Ida, you're supposed to have dinner ready for me when I get home. Y'all stop, I beat him with that laugh. Until he left the apartment with Melvin. Melvin, the child, watching, begging, pleading me to stop. So I left his ass. But to this day, that's the only man I've ever loved. I'm walking back with a brown book bag full of 2 gallons of peach Bacardi sagging off my back like my granddaddy's skin. I'm sitting in a royal blue yard chair, king dressed in club clothes. I vaguely remember the Jergens bottle on the dresser before leaving my room that day. Ruben said, all you Greensboro niggas is bitches. Y'all drink. I took offense. We passed that bottle like a 4x4 relay baton, and I was the winner, though I don't quite remember crossing the line. Tim said, yo, slow down, bro, you got all night. He said at some point I went down to smoke a cigarette, but I don't quite remember any of that. Matter of fact, I don't remember much of anything. Just waking up on a cold floor with a trash can. I wondered, while counting fluorescent lights, if I would die. If this is what it feels like to lay on a cold surface and have your insides slowly unraveled and torn apart to be on an autopsy table. I look my beautiful girlfriend in the face and explain to her how alcoholism has ran through my family. She looks back, smiles, she says, I love you, but if you become an alcoholic, then I'ma leave your ass. You are your own man, Trey, and you make your own decisions.